speaking, Victoria's air quality is very good by world standards, but there's always room for improvement. So the inquiry looked at a range of areas where there could be some improvements made. So the inquiry came in response to recommendation from the Parliament to inquire into the health impacts of air pollution. And particularly what we saw in the last few years was some significant incidents that impacted our air quality. So in the western suburbs, there were some industrial fires, and the recycling inquiry that preceded this inquiry looked at some of those issues. But also then we had a significant number of bushfires in 2018 and 2019. And so clearly that brought to mind for many Victorians the state of our air quality. We can impact people differently, but certainly if you're an asthmatic or you've got other chronic lung conditions, air quality can have a huge impact on your not only your mental health, but your physical health as well. What emerged in the inquiry was there were two areas, Melbourne's inner west and also the Latrobe Valley. Now, the Latrobe Valley's got a history of industrialisation, and it's been an ongoing issue for that area. But also in Melbourne's west, trucks, vehicle emissions are the things that are really front of mind for those particular populations. What the report goes to is looking to help people who might be not able to afford upgrading their heating, for example. So many people we found still rely on wood smoke heaters for warmth. And so that can, but also if you're a renter, for example, you may not have an option to upgrade your heating, even though you may want to. So we found that wood smoke heating, of course, particularly during winter time, did impact people's air quality. Not everyone, but it was a significant issue, particularly around in the colder months. We find it's a more of a particular issue in the inner suburbs of Melbourne. So what we're, some of the recommendations go to things like people being able to access a scheme where they can get support for removing their wood smoke heaters from their houses at the point of sale, for example. Another one might be if you're someone who's from a poor socioeconomic background, that there could be some system where government could assist you to remove those wood heaters and you could upgrade to more efficient forms of heating, either like reverse cycle air conditioning, for example. So some of the recommendations were to have like clean air zones, for example, so that if there is a childcare centre or a school, parents dropping off their children to schools, obviously they might be just stopping for a short time and then continuing on their journey. But the report looks into, or delves into how we could reduce vehicle idling around those areas. And because we know, and some of the evidence that we received during the inquiry is the health impacts of vehicle emissions on younger children particularly can have consequences for lifelong consequences. We looked at particularly Victoria's air quality monitoring network, and what we found was that people were very interested in receiving real-time information. So if people did have lung conditions, they might be able to make informed decisions about how they went about their day, for example. So if someone was an asthmatic, they may choose to go about their day later in the day when air quality improved, but having access to that real-time information was critically important. And certainly that came up as well for people who live in the Latrobe Valley, that they felt they could gain more control over perhaps their health and how they responded to poor air quality days by having that access to that information in a real-time way.